Stars are in many ways similar to living creatures. Like humans, they have life cycles.
Investigating stars' life cycles in the 1930s, two visionaries, Subramanian Chandrasekhar and Robert Oppenheimer, discover that the most massive stars end their lives very differently from smaller ones.
The life cycle of a star really depends on its mass. The mass of a star determines what's going to happen after it finishes burning its hydrogen fuel.
All stars start out burning hydrogen, the lightest atom, fusing hydrogen atoms into helium, working their way up to heavier elements. Gravity wants to crush the entire mass of the star, but the enormous energy released by fusion pushes outward, preventing the star from collapsing.
Stars are stable because we have an outward moving pressure due to nuclear fusion, and that's balancing with the inward force of gravity.
Smaller stars can't fuse elements heavier than helium. But in the most massive stars, fusion crushes heavier and heavier atoms, all the way up to iron.
Iron is such a massive element, it has so many protons in it, that by the time you fuse iron, you don't get any energy back out.
Iron is a dead end for stars. Fusing atoms larger than iron doesn't release enough energy to support the star. And without enough energy from fusion, keeping the star inflated, there's nothing to fight gravity.
And gravity wins. And so the entire star collapses.
Very rapidly, trillions of tons of material come crashing down, hit the dense core, and bounce back out, blowing off the outer layers of the star in a massive explosion. A supernova. The more mass, the more gravity. So if the remaining core is massive enough, gravity becomes unstoppable.
There's no known force to prevent the collapse to an infinitesimally small dot.
Gravity crushes the stellar core down smaller and smaller and smaller until all its mass is compressed in an infinitely small point. A black hole.